Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and welcome to another video in this series, Advanced Development in Grasshopper. I've said this like a million times already, but I'm not getting tired of it. So what are we doing in this video? I'm going to teach you how to define default parameters for the inputs of components. What do I mean with this? So if you remember when we created the construct vector component, we just defined that it can get x, y, z values, right? But we used this kind of pattern that David Rodden recommends for taking inputs, which is if getting the data from the input failed, just stop executing the component. All right, what that leads to, well, actually not exactly that, other things, but what one of the consequences of that is that if I do the following, for example, I just drop a simple construct vector with no inputs, then I get an error saying that X, Y, and Z failed to collect data, and I don't get any input, I don't get any vector output whatsoever. Whereas if I go to the actual native construct vector, this one here, if I drop it here, you can see that without any inputs, for some reason, there's already X, Y, and Z predefined values here, and I already get a 0, 0 vector, which is actually often very useful because very often we create zero vectors or vectors with just one input like X, Y, or Z, and it's kind of tedious to have to add zeros all the time. So what I would like to do is I would like to be able to define a way to add default parameters out of the box for certain parameters, for certain components. So for example, let's do that with our, construct vector component. So let's, first of all, let me try removing the pattern of if I didn't collect data, you have to fail, okay? So I'm going to do this and I'm going to add my semicolons here and I'm going to try and see what's going to happen. What's going to happen is that, let me show you, I'm going to do that right now. What is going to happen is that I'm going to drop a construct vector here and I still do get that same error. I still get the fail X, fail Y, fail Z for some reason, even though I am not canceling anything anytime here. And I actually do have default values for this variable, which is kind of weird. This is simply because Grasshopper is already managing stuff for us. Grasshopper, with the parameter manager and with all the additional stuff that goes into making Grasshopper work, Grasshopper is already taking care of looking at your inputs, figuring if there's any wire connected, and already gives you default errors for this. So then how could I add these default parameters? Well, if you remember, when I was adding number parameter or integer parameter or whatever, it actually, the method that I use actually has a bunch of different overloads. So let me actually so if I go to p manager.add number, for example, add number, and then I scroll through. So the basic overload was name, nickname, description, and access. If I scroll down through the overloads, you can see that the second overload comes with a default that I can add. And the third one comes with a list of default values in case the access is a list of elements, right? So what that means is that just by simply adding to the very end of the parameter, the value that I want as the default here, okay, that is just enough. That is all I need to do here. Okay, so let me actually now show you this in action. I'm going to execute this. I'm going to execute this. I'm going to open Grasshopper. And then I'm going to go here to drop a construct vector. And you can see that already I get a 0, a 0, and a 0 there. And V is already a 0, 0 component, a 0, 0 vector. All right. So that's just the way, the simple way to add default values to the inputs of. But then you may ask, then Jose, like, why are you even bothering at giving these default values? Well, This is actually not default values. This is starter values, just because of how C sharp as a language works. When we reference something, a value that is going to go into a primitive, that primitive has to be initialized. It's part of how C sharp works. The other thing is like, well, then why bother with this whole, like, if you didn't get data, then return, blah, blah, blah. Well, it's kind of a nice thing to do, because if you actually work with certain structures like trees or lists where there's no default, and there's like, you can actually have empty inputs and that is valid, then making sure that you have those additional safeguards, especially if your components, if your algorithm is very hefty, it has a lot of computation, you save yourself all that computation, or even if the very fact that one of these lists or trees or input elements might be null, if that could break your code and crash Grasshopper, that is actually still a good practice to avoid that by returning in time and not allowing invalid values like null elements, etc., go through down in the rest of your algorithm. Okay, so it's still a good idea to have, but for primitives, we can actually get away with default values here and not even checking this if else, if I didn't get data, etc., etc. Okay, beautiful. I think that was it for this video. And if you have noticed throughout these videos, the whole click and play, turning Rhino on, loading Grasshopper, etc., and loading this file that I use for debugging is kind of becoming a lot of overhead. So I think in the next video, what I'm going to teach you is a really quick trick to make sure that when we hit play here, Rhino opens, Grasshopper opens automatically as well, and we also load any file that we're using for debugging automatically. Okay, let me show you that on the next video. But in the meantime, like, sub, or not, whatever, okay? Thank you, see you on the next video, bye-bye.